Hello, so happy you could join me today on this beautiful day. It's a beautiful day here, and I hope it's a beautiful day wherever you're at. What we got going on here is a pre-stretched canvas, 16 by 20. What I did was I taped this off and painted the bottom portion with a coat of black gesso, and on top of that, I put a thin coat of liquid clear. On top, the top portion, I just loaded it up with a thin coat of liquid white. What I thought I'd do today is maybe a poinsettias, I'm not sure where, maybe on this side here, some ocean, maybe it's Hawaii, maybe some palm trees, maybe some seagulls, whatever. So any information and all the colors that you'll need to paint along with me will come across the screen right about here. So let's get started. We'll start out with the sky. I use a 2-inch brush, and I'm going to load it up with some purple color, alizarin crimson, fatal blue, prussian blue, kind of darker hue color, and mix it right up on the brush just like that. And we'll start out in the corners, crisscross strokes with that liquid white on there. It's going to blend it all in all the way across. Maybe get more blue, just mix it right on there. You get all kinds of different things happening right on your brush. I'm going to clean that off. I picked up some ocean color. We don't want that. But we'll blend that in. You get all this stuff happening automatically. Maybe there's a green hue to the sky there. Maybe it goes all the way down. The blender brush. I'm going to add a little bit of liquid white on there, just tapping it. I'm going to start out here and go up into the color, into the sky, and automatically it's going to pull all the different colors that's in the sky. Circular motion all the way down. All the way down to the horizon. We'll do the same over here. Leave some white areas, some lighter. You don't want to color it all in. You don't want to blend it all in. Just barely. All the way. Like that, you got some darker colors up there. I'm going to clean the brush off. I use odorless paint thinner. Take off the excess. Now what we're going to do is come in with the fan brush and load up some sky color. I'm going to get some liquid white, maybe some purple color. Purple color of the sky. Just like that. Maybe there's a cloud right here. You can just tap it, or you can do circular motions to get that fluffiness and all that stuff happening. Maybe this cloud comes all the way down. Maybe it's a big cloud and it goes right across the sky. Just like that. With your brush, the way it is, you're getting all kinds of colors that are coming right off the white. And it's just all mixed. You don't have to do anything. You're getting all that look of the sky. You're getting the clouds already in there. Circular emotions. Maybe that goes just like that. Maybe in our world we got some clouds over here. Just turn the brush over. Just like that. Got some things happening there. Maybe down here we got something. Put a little bit more color up. Maybe we got some white things, white clouds happening. Cleaning the brush off again because I just want to pick up just the white now. Where you might have some, like in here, where you might have some of the clouds that aren't storm clouds yet. So you just want to highlight maybe where there's some light hitting it. Circular motions. Maybe over here we got right on the edge there. Maybe where there's some light hitting that portion of it. Maybe it goes down just like that. Wherever you think, that's exactly where it should be. Okay, I'm going to take that blender brush and use just the corner of it and blend some of this in. That fluffiness of the clouds. Don't want to do too much though. Just here and there and there and here. Circular motion, you want to have those layers. Maybe we can come back in now and put another layer of clouds right behind this one. Maybe right here. Circular motion. That. Take that blender brush again. Circular motion, just barely tapping to make another layer. Another layer behind that one. Just like that. Got some things happening there. I see is, I'm going to brighten this up right here. I'm going to brighten that up there and go right across. The clouds are like all over. Got all kinds of things happening. Maybe over here there's some light hitting it. Maybe some light up here. Maybe at the top. Maybe at the top of the cloud. cleaning the brush off again because I'm going to go into some just plain white. As soon as we fill in some ocean color, I'm going to use phthalo green, phthalo blue, going to load it right up on both sides on a 2-inch brush, just like that. You're going to come across here and start putting it in. On this black, it's going to show up once we start putting the white on. Maybe right in this area down the middle, we'll leave that lighter for the reflection of the water. And maybe down here, we're going to have some poinsettias. So I'm not sure that we're going to use any too much green down there. I'm just scraping it in because I want to get that color when you put that white on there. It's really going to bring out that ocean green, the green blue. Maybe down here. Who knows? Here and there, and there and here. Scraping it in. Now, I'm going to take the other brush. I'm going to put some brown for the sandy area. Maybe down here. Maybe some yellow. We'll pull up. Get that reflection. Maybe some white. Really get it. I'll take the blender brush and we'll pull up for the reflection all the way. Get that glassy look from the sand. Go right across. Just like that. So now you got that lightness down there. Now we'll come in and we'll start putting in some water. Just like that on the fan brush. I'm going to come in and I'm going to tap this all along the edge. Maybe there'll be more in here. We're going to have that reflection of the water coming down. Tapping like this, you're getting the illusions. That's what we're trying to create, of distant waves here and there. Because you're not going to see a lot of detail if you ever look out in the ocean. You'll see some dark. Almost looks black. The ocean is so, the water is so deep there. You might see some waves crashing in, but you won't see too much stuff happening. Just kind of happening all over out there. might see some white caps. And that's okay if you press a little harder with the corner of the brush like that. Maybe you can't see that from home or wherever you're at. But here it pulls it up. Man, some more white. I'm going to come in here and highlight some of this area right in the middle here. Right where I said there'll be more of a reflection. It'll be lighter. It'll be lighter right in through here. And I'm just tapping with the corner. Trying to keep a straight edge, a straight line going across, because otherwise it'll look like your water's falling off the canvas, and we don't want that. I just want to go here and there, leaving the gaps in between. It's okay to have some lighter, whiter areas. That could be where the waves are coming in, crashing out in the ocean. Grabbing some more. I'm using my arm underneath my other arm here as a brace. It helps you keep instead of trying to hold your arm up. It's like placing it on something, on maybe part of the canvas or whatever. But this way, it's kind of better for me. So I'm going to highlight the center part a little bit more with the white. Because we want that to pop a little bit more than the rest of it. And over here it can be all real rough coming in. Who knows? If you're getting a good idea of this here, it's really not that hard. It's just how you would see the ocean. What you might visualize it if you get a chance to go to the ocean, or you live by the ocean, or that's a big kind of wave coming in right there. Just like that is good. Got some stuff happening underneath it. Like I said, the harder you tap, you get some of that white off of there. And that's what you're looking for. Like that. A little time consuming, but you want to get that illusion, and that's what we're creating, and it looks pretty good. Maybe here we'll get some waves coming in this way, a little darker. There and there. This is kind of a little different than the way I used to do waves. I used to do them more, maybe what you might consider traditional or whatever. But just to practice in and trying different things, I came up with this, giving me the best illusion. Got some more white, I'm gonna tap it right in there. Right where I might think we'd have some of that brighter. Maybe back in here it's going to be brighter. Right to the horizon. Put one wave in here using the fan brush, loading it up with liquid white, just like that. We'd have a smaller wave coming back in through here, maybe. Just gonna tap it. And just have it start to break. Stuff back here. Just using the corner of the brush. Leaving the blackness because it looks like there's waves coming in. Now what we'll do, I'm going to wipe off that fan brush and I'm going to pull back that wave where it might be, where you might see it starting to break. Just pulling from the white on the angle of the wave. And that white will blend right down and make it look like foam and mist, and the way a wave would look coming in, crashing in right there. Just coming right across. Maybe it's more of an angle here because it's closer to, it broke already. I'm going to fill in this right here. Get some things happening over here, breaking this up, this edge right here. Just goes into, who knows? Okay, now take some more white. Gonna make the bigger wave. The wave that's coming in right here and breaking. So we're loading that two fan brush up again. And we're going to determine where we want it to be. I think right here is good. taking the corner of the brush. This don't have to be straight. And maybe it'll break right here. Just like that. Maybe this is where it breaks here. Maybe it goes up there. I'm just going to tap this down, this corner here, this edge. Because we're going to pull that down. Like that. Gonna highlight more on top with the whiter. Just like that. Goes right over. Make this bigger. Sharpening up this edge here. Just like that. Now, I take this filbert brush, load it up with cadmium yellow, maybe some sap green. It's liquid clear. Tap it and leave that space there. You want that blackness right there. That black edge. Go into some white. Want it lighter. Lighter. Maybe it goes all the way back here. Goes all the way down. That starts the eye of the wave. More white. Right at the top. Just tapping it. Add a pull. Let a pull from it. Fan brush, and we'll start getting the eye of the wave, the look of it. Now you might see it. Some white, yellow again. Tap that. Look at the fan brush. Pull it down. Start grabbing from some of this white up here. Just like we did at that back wave. Gonna be more foamy here on because the wave already broke. And the angles are gonna be a little bit different. This is right where it's starting to break here. Of things happening. Just like that. Having it all come in. Now, I'm going to add some more white and yellow. Dabbing it in here some more. I want that brighter. That eye right there. Just tapping that because you want to defuse that a little bit. You don't want to take that away. Now we're going to take the blender brush, clean off the excess, come in and blend the wave. Pull down. Add some white color here. When it's coming in, you want this to highlight it. Gonna pull that down. Right across that line, just like that. Maybe a little bit more white. Like that. Pull down again. Tapping it. Going across there. Just about like that. Maybe some over here. Maybe some over the top of the wave where you might see some of the reflection, but it won't be close. You have that darkness there. Just tapping it. You want to keep that edge. Knock off the excess. And go across, tapping it, pull it up, got that glossiness right there. Maybe we'll go over here, put some over here. That's what I see. Like that. Looks pretty good. Now, I'm going to clean this one brush off here. some foam, the waves crashing in. Could you use liquid white? Maybe some liquid clear. Liquid clear. Some liquid white. Just kind of pushing down. We're getting like a round edge. You want to come in here and just tap up, pick the side that you think would give you the best foam. Or it would be crashing. Grab some more. Like that. I'm going to take the palette knife and we're going to scrape in an area where we might think that there's a big stone here. Going right down. Just like that. Take some browns. Marbleize it, just like that. And be just like when we come in and we put our mountains in. We're just worried about the top edge. Just like that. That off in some darker color. Darker all the way to the bottom. Just like that. It goes over there. Maybe we'll take some white and maybe some brown, marbleize it, highlight some areas here. Everywhere there's some light hitting it. Dark. Just put it in. Wherever you think the shadows might be, what would be darker? Barely tap it. Now we'll take the fan brush, some liquid white, put a little bit of water line right down at the bottom here. Just tapping this. That water look. Now what we can do is put put some palm trees in. Use that fan brush loaded up with some brown colors. Liquid clear, make it thinner. Load it right up on the brush. Just like that. And we're going to come in and, you know, I'm not sure. I think I'm going to leave this side alone. I'm going to come in here with some palm trees. Just tapping it all the way down. Tap it a little.